What's going on out there?
You guys doing okay?
What's that girl doing?
Good, good.
I saw that.
So far. Making new friends. Making a lot of new friends in Canada.
You know what I mean, Chuck?
So how's the tour going?
So far.
We're still alive.
Yeah. How long have you been on the road?
Which is amazing.
How long have you been on the road?
The end of this
month,
it'll be a year.
A year.
A year?
Yeah, we spent last Halloween in a Denny's. Yeah. That's when we left home and said,
We've spent every holiday in a Denny's.
You guys originally from LA?
We own Denny's.
Right? You started off in LA?
Yeah.
Yeah, but I'm originally from Cleveland, Ohio.
And you?
That's why I dress this funny. I'm from Los Angeles.
Because every metal band lives in LA, but they're from somewhere in America. And everybody sort of trucks
LA's like the heavy metal melting pot in the U.S. But this is like our first time up to Canada, so this is an eye-opening experience. We didn't expect the reaction that we're getting. We didn't know if anyone would know who we were. And we come up here and people are like, and they're like, cool.
That's great. I hear that your live shows are energetic, to say the least.
Yeah.
Have you
it's
ever
like an electric
sustained?
Circus,
you have know? You ever sustained serious injuries?
Can I tell them?
Yes.
Go ahead. We've had quite a few.
What happened?
One show. This is probably the worst injury we've ever had. Jani.
Are you going to tell that one?
No, I can't.
Hope my mom isn't listening. Go
She's
ahead.
Not.
I don't care.
She's
All right. We were playing a place called the Roxy in Hollywood. Anyways, Jani was laying on the floor, and Joey came up and got on top of him, and Jani had his mic right here. Okay, and
we
Joey.
We can't see where, but we
Joey
can,
bent,
can
use Joey your squatted down and pinned something like his, you know, his tool.
And Jani hit a high note.
Very high note.
There was lacerations all over it.
I had to be rushed to the hospital.
I thought he would never have kids.
I ran upstage. It was the worst pain I ever felt in my life, and I ran upstage, and I pulled my pants down, and there was blood everywhere, and I went, "Oh my God, I'm never gonna have kids. That's it. I'm shot." And they rushed me to the hospital, and it turned out it was okay and everything. I don't even have any scars. You want to check? No, I'm joking.
Funniest thing was the nurse.
But I don't have any scars.
The nurse
anything.
Kept saying, and, you know, who bit you? Who bit you? Are you
yeah,
in a,
they
are you in a bondage?
They kept
or what?
Thinking it was like,
we're a, like no, he just
I brought
happened
this up,
on stage.
She
goes, this is a human fault. Bite. And I said, it's not a human bite, I swear.
Can I change the subject very quickly
Her
now?
Her name was Jaws.
So your album is called, I'm not. I the am. Album is called Dirty, Rotten, Filthy, Stinking Rich.
Oh, you said
this
that
is
right.
the album right here.
That's
kind of
like the ultimate,
cover.
The universal dream.
But now, you guys me. Are. I mean, your album's
no,
selling
we're
well.
Not.
They, you know what? They
we
say
don't get
the check
any of that
is in
money.
The mail.
Yeah.
It's in the pipeline, man.
Everybody
we'll get
keeps
it to
telling
you as soon
us we're
going to
make money, but we haven't seen any yet.
How come?
I don't know.
How do you make money in this business?
You don't. It's
you
very
do what
expensive.
You do,
right.
I guess.
No, you don't.
Go back to school and be a lawyer.
Really? Be a lawyer, be a manager. That's how you make money.
Really?
No, we're doing they okay now. We like we've graduated up from like frozen dinners to like better frozen dinners.
Yeah, you know. Almost McDonald's, really.
We can afford beer now, so that's cool.
You guys are one of those bands that people say, "Oh yeah, they're good and they dress great." You're known as a band with a great image.
We dress great, man. Hey,
dress great.
Where'd you buy the shirt? Saks Fifth Avenue.
Yeah. Where do you guys shop? Where do you do all your
we
image
shop.
Collecting?
We go to radio stations and steal their shirts and
Goodwill. Let's see. Where do we shop?
We don't really shop.
Is it important?
Mostly when you meet a really nice girl and she takes you back to her house, then you go through her closet.
You're like,
can
buy
anything
can
that
I
fits
I
you,
a
and
pair
then you
sweats?
Beg No, I'm joking. Where do we show?
No, your underwear won't fit me.
Is image really important to the band, or does it not matter?
When we get on stage, we feel it is because we're there to entertain people.
Mm-hmm. Right. You know, we kind of have the attitude, dress how you want to dress and don't apologize for it, you know? I hate people who I don't hate anyone, but I dislike it when a band will come out and they'll dress a certain way, and then as soon as they get off stage, they're apologizing for it. Yeah, well, you know, we just kind of do it because, you know, I'm really sorry. Well, next album we won't. It's like, just do what you want to do, and if somebody doesn't like it, you know,
they don't like it.
Then I guess you won't come and see us again.
Can't
but we have fun. I mean,
everybody.
It's not true. Like, it's I mean, true. We don't get out there and walk around with limp wrists and wear a lot of pink and purple and stuff.
What's
I mean,
wrong
we
with
headbang.
Pink? I like pink
fine
very
for
much.
You.
Okay, fine.
No, actually, so our color, okay.
No, we get headbang, we sweat, there. We get out. It's a great show. It's really live. It's
okay.
In your face.
Let me tell you something. When we were going to do this interview, first of all, it was going to be shown on our segment called The Power Hour, which is an hour of straight metal. And then the bosses, whoever, said, no, this isn't necessarily a metal band. This should be in our regular programming. Now, how do you feel about that? Do you consider yourselves to be a metal band?
We cross over. I mean, there's ballads and there's really heavy stuff on the record.
Best of both worlds, really.
And we just got done demoing in Florida. We got done demoing
new
about eight songs
heavier.
For the new records. And that's
so you better
even
tell your boss to have us back
now.
On this show again.
So
when the new stuff comes out.
I think everybody gets all, even guys, I mean, there's a lot of guys who are really into thrash, hard rock, which we listen to it too. I listen to everything from Metallica to Bobby Brown. You know, we don't have a closed mind or tunnel vision about music. But even the guys who really get into the heavy stuff still, you know, when a ballad comes on, maybe when they're around their friends, you know, they go, oh, wimp rock. But, you know, they can relate to it.
They get behind closed
doors. I like heavy
metal. You can hear
I grew up
on
Judas Priest and Thin Lizzy and all that kind of stuff. And I still like a nice song.
These bands like Aerosmith, you know, they have a song.
They have the ability to write
something
heavy or something really light.
That's kind of how we picture ourselves as being.
You know, you guys look pretty darn good for being on the road for 1 year. What do you live in, this tiny little bus, traveling on a bus?
Yeah. We just got a really nice
bus. Big bus.
Matter of fact, we're getting a bigger one.
Really?
Yeah, because we just, we're going to finish up in Canada. We go to Alaska for a few shows. Then we pick up in the United States on the West Coast with Bad English opening for us. And then starting November 16th, we go out with Motley Crue all over the U.S. and hopefully back up to Canada by February or so.
But do you I hate to bring this up, but do you take it easy a bit on the road? Or do you cut your faces off? Because,
no,
I mean, you really
what did Mickey Six say? He said, if you guys keep up this Animal House stuff, you're going to be dead in 2 weeks. And we said, funny, we've been doing it for a year now.
No, it just gets crazier, actually. We have like 5 cases of beer on a rider. We can't sleep at night. We sleep all day, stay up all night. We always go to a club after we play.
We have a, I don't know what you say, kind of a thing we always do is when I'm on stage, I talk a lot.
Did you
really?
Notice that?
I talk a lot on stage. You know, I like to get to know people. I don't do the old, you know, the traditional
sit
rock star
bus.
Role. You know,
bye,
good evening.
See you, it's been real.
Good night, thank you. You know, I just rap with people. I'm kind of a redneck, so.
He's really going to be a politician.
The ritual? Is that the ritual?
No, the ritual is we always announce to the crowd what club we're going to go party at after the show and invite them all down to drink
a beer. Okay, well, tonight you're in Toronto.
Where should we go?
What's the rock and roll club here?
You're playing tonight at where? The concert hall?
Yeah.
Well, I think Rock and Roll Heaven will probably be.
Rock and Roll Heaven. We will be there live.
We will bring you to heaven. We'll show you the back
of the
bus.
Wow, it's called Heaven now, isn't it?
Yeah.
We have a video from Heaven.
That's right.
See
you there?
So why don't we let you guys go do your sound check. We will play your video. Thank you very, very much for
can we eat some of the food that just came in?
Yeah, they got
pizza. Miss Walsh?
Please.
Do you have any pizza?
We're starving.
We're dying over here.
All right, we'll get you some pizza.
They said no way.
No.
They said go hit Kentucky Fried
Chicken.
Right.
Don't worry about
no
it. You guys
said get a real job.
Here.
What do we got?
Have yourself.
That's
go ahead.
Me. Oh, we can do it right on the air?
Yeah, well, this is much music. We live here.
This is all much right. One better. I'm fine.
No, go ahead. Come on.
No, I'm
don't
all right.
Be a wimp. Come on, have your pizza.
I might get a little pizza on my mouth.
Don't be a wimp. Here we go. This is Warrant on Much Music. And eat up the whole piece. Have the whole thing.
That's fine.
Oh, yummy.